Hi, it's Jamie with Jamie's Arts a la Carte. Thank you very much for joining me. I have a fun project planned for us today. I hope this video inspires you to create something of your own. If you would, hit the like button and share the video with your friends. That helps me to grow this channel and to continue to bring you new projects. If you haven't subscribed yet, would you please consider subscribing? And if you have, thank you very much. Well, we have a lot to do, so let's get to it. Hi, it's Jamie with Jamie's Arts a la Carte. Thank you so much for joining me today. I've got a project that I wanted to try, something I've never done before, which is kind of our common theme. But we've got a couple of these. I've got a few of these that are out in the man cave getting cut into pieces like this. That'll get glued to create. I'm going to create a tier tray. And I want to decorate the edge with these little wooden balls. I'm going to just put it on a simple string so that I think it will hold together better. Well, let's see what we can do with this one. We got a lot to do, y'all. Let's get to it. All right. Our feet have set up. They're not completely dry, but they've set up. Our beads are tacked together. So now what I'm going to do is go ahead and glue these strings of beads around the edge and then let it set up completely, probably overnight. So let's see how we are going to start this. Our glue has set up. That's our center post. Beads are on there. Legs and beads are on this one. So now I'm going to clean this and this, glue these together, let the glue dry, then I'll be able to paint. Okay. Little bit of weight on there. All right, we'll let it dry again.
Well, there's our first coat. I probably should have painted that wood to begin with. It's soaking up a lot of paint. So we'll see how this goes.
I needed to rethink how to work on this tray. There was a chemical reaction and my paint buckled. Not sure why, but I had to figure out how was I going to fix it. All right, so what I came up with is that I'm going to do a light sanding on the top up here. And then I'm going to create a faux finish. I'm just going to sand it. See all that loose paint that's there. And it's rough over here. It didn't bubble quite like that, but I'm just going to give the tray a light sanding. Something like that. Before I start painting though, I noticed that one of these areas, one of the little beads came loose. So I was like, okay, well that's not good, right? Because that's not going to be very, like the longevity of this gift. I just won't really work like that, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my twine, and I picked a pretty thick twine. I'm going to soak it in one part water, two parts glue, and I'm going to put it up in here on the inside and the outside and try to shore that up a little bit, right? Try to give it a little bit more stability. So we got our top, our center, and our bottom done. I will just sit here and fiddle with it while it dries until it seems to set up just right. All right, we're gonna let it dry and then we'll come back to it and see what our next step will be. Ooh, what a project. So I went in and I added that glue, the hot glue around here after the regular glue had dried. So now I'm going to come in and I'm going to give everything a base coat in chalk paint, right? We've sanded it, wiped it all down. The way I make my chalk paint is I do one part Plaster of Paris. All right, just keep it in this big baggie. And then one part water, one part paint. So let's see if I can do this without making a mess.
Thank you.
Right, I want to add cord around this little thing here. And then we're going to paint the legs and underneath this so that when I flip it over, once it's dry, it's all will all be taken care of. So let's go ahead and get our first little row of glue on here. I think that'll do it. We can get glue gun melted. We can get this out here though. Done with paint. We'll use a little bit of moss and our flowers will decorate it, and it'll just be a nice little lovely little display. Saw one place that looked pretty dark, so I'm just gonna lighten it up. Should do that all the way around, just look at it. All right, we'll let it dry thoroughly before we start gluing stuff to it. We get out our new toy here. Ooh, this is what we'll be opening next. Wanted one of those for a while. It's a glue pot. Try not to burn my fingers anymore. All right, we've got ourselves a dry little tray. I think it came out good. Probably would do a few things different. Like, I wouldn't apply the hot glue. And I like the two-tone beads. I might do that before. But yeah, overall, I think it turned out cute. All right, so now we're gonna decorate. So I have all these little succulents that I found at different places, Dollar Tree, Walmart, just wherever I happen to be. And these in the little pot, I'm gonna remove. And yeah, I'm gonna do something with the pots. We'll see. But I wanna get the things out. But before I start all that, I wanna show you my new little gadget. So I've been wanting what they call a hot pot, right? So this is skillet glue. Put it in the skillet, plug it into the outlet, turn your control knob temperature to where you want it. They recommend not using all the way to hot. If you do, it will overheat the glue and then it won't bond as well. Okay, that's good to know. Then once it's melted, you just dip your stuff in there and then put it right on your project. And you can just leave the glue right in here and then you warm it up and melt it the next time. How about that? Pretty cool. I read the directions, y'all. Okay. So let's get this heating up. First time, so it hasn't ever been warmed up, so it'll probably take it just a minute. All right, it's plugged in. We're gonna put it on about a third of the way and we're gonna turn it on. Probably don't wanna touch that while it's on. Set it over there. Okay, I did send my husband out to go get some moss because I have an idea with the tray that I want to use that with. So here are, these came from the Dollar Tree. See, look, they just, yeah. So we'll do this, and you know I'm going to save that, right? I'll save all these because now I need glue dippers. This is what came off the flowers. So if you do get something like this from Dollar Tree or wherever, they just pop out. You do want to, it won't just pull out. You can, the these do, right? And then this will actually just pull out of there, and then you have that piece. And then here, with these, just gently I'm thinking of that very bottom piece when we make those flowers for the cemetery, this would be good. Soft and pliable. Okay. my thought was just to place a little bit around this just to give it a little bit of an accent. So, ooh, look at there, you can dip it. Oh, it dries quick though.
Thank you. Thank you.
here is our tray. We're all done. We got to learn how to use our glue pot. I think it came out super cute. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, like it, share it with your friends. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, would you please consider subscribing? And well, until next time, happy crafting! All right, I'll bring you in and I'll do some close-ups for you.